beautiful experience with her. Dumb enough to walk away from love that she shared. Think he would get over until he got sober and realized the things that he did to her. I could never bring myself to break her heart. I could never keep this love and never ever part. And forever, I will always treasure this shalom. Now worry yourself, she will get blessing from above.
Give me the reason why.
Why can't I get over you?
Ooh.
Finding it so hard to.
No.
Knowing that you moved on.
Oh, man, you're 5 lakhs. The man's been calling me. 5 lakhs.
Stupid.
What about you being angry?
In a land of timeless beauty, he was a man of peace.
Yo, Ahmed, man, relax, man, with the Quranist thing, man. It's all fake news, man. Fake news, bro. Come on, man.
Well, the Quran is fake news, eh?
Fake news, bro. Remember, I had 2 hours,
you
3 hours
debate. You're calling the Quran fake news?
Remember, I had like 2-3 hours debate with him in the park, man.
No, but you telling me the Quran is fake news, though?
Of course, man. Fake news, man.
Mm-hmm.
Whoa, fake news, obviously. It's Fox News, man.
The fake news. It's fake. Phony. Fake. A few days ago, I called the fake news the enemy of the people, and they are. They are the enemy of the people.
That's gonna get a soundbite.
Imagine calling the Quran fake news, sir.
I don't like them putting chemicals in the water that turn the friggin' frogs gay.
Yo, Ahmed, man, relax, man, with the Quran machine, man. It's all fake news, man. Fake news, bro. Come on, man.
Well, the Quran is fake news, eh?
Fake news, bro. Remember, I had 2 hours.
What in the Quran fake news?
Remember, I had like 2-3 hours debating in the park, man.
No, but you telling the Quran is fake news, though?
What's my fake news, man?
Whoa,
fake news, obviously. It's Fox News, man.
That's what they're saying, man.
Imagine calling the Quran fake news, man.
Allah. For 75 years, I ask Allah. And I pray, I fast. And I asked Allah to show me something. Allah was silent. But 60 seconds was the Lord Jesus Christ. 60 seconds was Jesus Christ. He set me free.
If you believe in Allah,
He set me free from the wrath of God. He set me free from sexual immorality. I used to have a different girlfriend. By the way, I lost my virginity with a woman. I never saw her again. And you may lose your virginity with a man, you will never see her. You will never see him again.
I saw the guy I lost my virginity with last week.
Well,
them type of women are why the UK is so bad. And, you know, they get drunk on the weekend, they cheat, they sleep around. You know, it's these women that we, in Islam, we only have the finest women. We have the best women. You know, we have women that have morals, that are modest. You know, it was very much a big part of coming to understand Islam when I was that young,
They kind of sold your men side of Islam. And if you don't want to go through heartbreaking again, if you don't want your heart to crash again, if you don't want to put your PJs on, turn romantic movie and ice cream in front of it to watch telly, then Islam is perfect religion for that. Because the way we discipline our wives, our daughters, you will never go through that breakups.
Yeah, and even if a wife displeases you, you know, there is things that you can banish her to the bedroom. You could, you know, you can there's more control. And especially back then I was young, you know, I looked at things differently as the way I do now.
Don't give me that excuse, brother. 17 is not young. Now in England...
So, according to Surah 33 verse 40, Muhammad is not father to anyone.
No.
And also Muhammad is the seal of the Prophet. Sister, is it correct? Context of the verse is really Muhammad is about to get married with the wife of his adopted son. That's the context that reason Muhammad
very
is
sad. Yeah, very sad.
So we've got a seal of Prophet who thinks it's all right to get married your wife.
adopted son, his son.
Wife of his adopted
wife
son.
Of his adopted son. Who was the one who decided that he should marry the wife of the adopted son?
Allah.
Allah.
You don't believe the Quran. Every show is to be a Christian. Show these Muslims they don't believe the Quran. We show them the proof and the evidence. They don't want to have it.
I'll show you the evidence.
Speak to me, don't speak to the camera.
Allah stepped in and Allah helped out Muhammad and said, dear Muhammad, get married with Zainab.
So why would Allah break up a marriage?
Because context of the verse is, Muhammad wants to visit his adopted son Zaid, and as Muhammad goes to Zaid's house, Muhammad sees Zainab almost half naked.
The wife was almost half naked, not properly dressed.
Yes, and suddenly, seal of the prophet has lustful feelings. He cannot control himself, and he sees Zainab half naked. What happened to Zaid? Zaid wants to divorce his wife for the sake of Muhammad.
Okay, so that's wrong on so many different levels.
I don't have nothing against you. I love you for the sake of God, right?
Just my friend. No, 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 no.
Nice
you, do you know what is al-bara' wal wala? Do you know what is bara' wal wala?
Yeah. Love for the sake of God.
Love the one.
But I love you.
Love and hate
but
the one.
You.
God
but,
hates.
But I love you.
Though. So God hates people.
No, but I like you. But I like you.
No, read. Al-Ikhwan was a teacher. Read.
Sir, are you Muslim?
Yes.
Can you help us to understand?
I don't believe of Al-Bukhari.
Okay, no, tell no. us.
Because is that the Prophet came as an example.
Yes.
And that is
yes.
forbidden.
Muhammad came in as an example. And example is, get married with your daughter-in-law.
Let me tell you, let me help you. This is what the Quran says. Allah is saying. He's done this. We married her to you in order that then not be upon the believers any discomfort, any guilt. This is what it says concerning the wives of their claims, i.e., adopted sons that may no longer have need of them. What does it mean when you no longer have need of your wife? What does that mean?
Whenever you marry someone, your adopted son,
you
adopted son,
you no longer have need of your wife.
You can now marry.
What is the use permissible? Of the
before it wasn't permissible.
What is the use of a wife that you?
She was married to Zaid, and then Muhammad, he is the best example to mankind, tells he is going to get married with his daughter-in-law. That is disgusting. That is disgusting.
The first one in the Quran to say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim was Surah An-Naml.
Okay. Man's an ex-Muslim, bro. Man's an ex-Muslim, bro. Ex-Muslim, bro. It's ex-Muslim.
It's about time. Your Muslim countries have been ruined by the jihadi ideology. Look at Syria, look at Iraq, look at Afghanistan, look at
Is there anyone in the crowd thinks it is not disgusting? A prophet, example to mankind, gets married with his wife of his adopted son. Anyone thinks that's a good thing? No, no one thinks that's a good thing, sir. Maybe only you who thinks that's a good thing. That's disgusting thing.
You know, if he's left Islam, he can leave Islam. Islam doesn't rely on individuals. Like you have these black Israelites, like these people who walk, like they, you know. Come. No, there was a brother here, ex-Muslim, and he was saying that he was threatened. But that apparently
was Muslim.
And I said, come, show me. I said, because it's rare. Someone's going to switch on someone because they left Islam.
Yeah.
I was like, he's probably a junkie or something. Do you get it?
You don't think it's maybe got some credence to it though? Maybe not they threatened him to take him out.
I wouldn't say to kill or to harm,
yeah.
But maybe some kind of
like
harass. Oh, harass maybe. Maybe, yeah. But he was saying that, you know, the thing. But I said, no, I don't believe that.
You know, a punishment.
So you, let's say, when you become a Muslim, no one told you about the law of apostasy. But soon after you left Islam, you've seen the side effects of it.
Yeah, I'd seen people get very upset at the fact that I left Islam, and I gave valid reasons why, and I was quite stern on them reasons, and they did not like that. It was a group of about, say, five lads, you know, that wanted to not only just get the books back out of my room that I had, like Bukhari, Muslim, and all of the hadith. They wanted to teach me a lesson. So when I came down the stairs, they were already equipped with knives and guns, and they just said, right, we're just gonna, you know, I'll stab straight through here. If I can get my sleeve up, stab through there, and shot through the leg, you know. So you stab in there, you know, stabbed.
It was peaceful and very amazing religion. The moment when people find out you don't want that religion anymore, they want to slide you off.
Not in accordance with Islam. A lot of Muslims still do it, even if you think it's not occurring with Islam. We do get a lot of threats. That's not a lie. Even
you get threats for what? Because probably if you're insulting Islam.
No.
No one's gonna pick on you if you're going about your business.
Let me tell you the things that you change. You said you don't do it. You don't care.
Just because I don't doesn't mean others don't. I understand that.
The third thing you said, in this country,
yes,
most of the death threats that ex-Muslims get, yes, is not in this country. We're talking about ex-Muslims that live in Saudi Arabia, in Bangladesh, in Pakistan, in Iran, in Indonesia, in Malaysia.
Yeah.
Those are the ex-Muslims that are getting the death threats. I have received death threats, but that's not nearly as much.
I received death threats.
I know, I'm just
saying. No, you're not paying attention from the far right.
I wasn't saying you're missing my point. I'm saying it wasn't a big deal. My death threats is not a big deal.
Yeah.
I live in a free country, I'm protected. I'm talking about the death threats that ex-Muslims in Iran and Saudi Arabia and Bangladesh and Pakistan. Those ex-Muslims living there, they are living in fear.
Okay?
And even, I understand that you're saying you don't think that's Islamic, but those...
No, I never said that.
Right.
In an Islamic country, there is laws and regulations. Yeah?
Right.
Okay.
Right.
So, you have heard of something called social contracts?
Right.
Have you heard of it? We have social contracts.
Yeah,
nobody came and asked you. Do you agree, this, you are born into it? Yeah, Immanuel Kant and...
I know.
Yes, so Muhammad Hijab talked about this in detail, yeah?
Yeah.
So the thing is, don't make this exclusive to Islam. Apostasy laws is there once again?
I didn't.
Once again, it's there. If an Islamic country has that in place, you don't need to live there. You can go.
They can't go.
No, you can go. We live in the 21st century.
No.
You can go.
People in
Excuse me, if I left Islam in Saudi Arabia, I will save my ticket and I will migrate to another
country. No, then you don't know. It's impossible for most people to get a visa to leave Iran.
I come from Iran. So about 31 years ago, I became a Christian. Two of my brothers been executed by the regime of Iran. One was a scientist, another was a lecturer University of Tehran. Their name, Nasser and Masoud. The said brother been tortured 9 years and been under the ice up to here. 9 years. And after that, they released him. But because they tortured him, he became drugs addict, and he's totally mental, and he's in blacklist. He cannot come back out of Iran. He cannot come out of Iran. I am exiled from Iran. I will be executed if I go back to Iran for two reasons. One, because I am politically active. I was and I am. Number two, I have to be executed again because I'm a born again Christian. I found Jesus, I found love, I found forgiveness, I found grace.
And there was a threat, wasn't there? Yeah, Allah is going to curse Allah, Gabriel, the righteous of the believers, the angels, and all his assistants are going to curse the women unless they get on board. So, Allah, angels, righteous of believers, is going to curse the wives if they become disobedient to Muhammad or they attack.
back to Muhammad because Muhammad slept with someone else.
Where is the gospel?
Another disgusting and disaster thing is happening with Muhammad in the court.
So, hi there.
Hello.
And who am I speaking to today?
My name is Hatun Taş. I am part of DCCI Ministries, Defend Christ Critic Islam. One of the things we do is we come to Speakers Corner week after week, mainly to engage with Islamic Dawah team by defending Christ, also critiquing ideology of Islam.
And today, what will you be speaking about?
Today we talked about the stoning verses of the adulteries. In Muslim countries, it is something practiced, yet something happened in 7th century. A ship came and then ate the verse. Today, it is not in the Quran. We were challenging the eternal word of Allah. It's not as a complete book. Also, we are talking about the Hajj, why people go to Hajj. Approximate 2 million people are in Hajj for 10 days. And one of the practice they will be doing is kissing the black stone. It is, in a sense, committing shirk, yet 2 million people are following that because Muhammad did something. So we are questioning the shirk in Islam, and also we are questioning why to kiss the black stone in Mecca.
Okay,
you... Arabic Quran, which one is your
own? The Quran which come through memory through the Prophet.
Was it the Quran of Abu Huwaib in Ka'b? Or was it the Quran of Masud? Which or was it the Quran of Musa?
The corrupted one, isn't it?
No, Quran is corrupted and I know it's very heartbreaking. It's been good. Okay. We talked about Jesus, we asked questions about Islam, and here we are. Another day at Speaker's Corner.
That's great. I just like bought you something. It's some tissues.
Why is that?
Well, because Hatun have been looking on the internet and loads of people are calling you a hate creature.
They do call me a hate creature even at Speaker's Corner.
So I was wondering if you were going to burst into tears or something.
No, I'll pass it on you. Why do people call us hate creature? Are we hate creature, Lizzie?
Well, the internet seems to think so. People uncomfortable truths that they don't want to hear, things that they've never had to confront before about Islam.
Yeah. One of the reasons because Muslims never been accountable and never been able to stand and defend Islam. And at Speaker's Corner, we are asking questions to Muslims to defend Islam, defend Allah, defend Muhammad, and defend the Quran. When they fail to do that, only thing is they do is you are hate preacher. I come to Speaker's Corner, one of the things I learned from Speaker's Corner is whatever you say, you have to back up your claims, okay? So, all my quotations mainly goes back to the Quran or goes back to the Hadith. Let me just read a couple of verses for you.
Okay.
And then see if, as a Christian, I am hate preacher, okay. Or does Islam teaching something about people to be hate preacher? Surah 5, verse 51. All you who believe, do not take Jews and Christians for friends.
Okay.
Does Islam
That doesn't teaching, sound very loving.
Does Islam teaching Muslims to love Jews and Christians?
Doesn't sound like that.
Okay. Surah 98 verse 6. Surely, those who disbelieve from among the followers of the book and the polytheists shall be in the hellfire as they are the worst of men. Is that loving?
No, I wouldn't say so.
That comes from the Quran. And Allah does not unbelievers. That's not very loving. That's not very loving. Strive hard against the unbelievers and hypocrites. Is that loving? No.
It sounds like hate preaching.
Should be, it says, they should be murdered or crucified. Or their hands and feet should be cut off an opposite side.
Where's that from
That's
again?
Surah 5 verse 33. A
And when you look at the Quran, when you look at the teachings of Islam, Islam doesn't tell Muslims, oh my lovely followers, go and love Christians and Jews. Islam doesn't do that. Yet we come to Speakers Corner and we tell people why the religions you follow don't do that.
Well, actually, to be honest, that's our crime, isn't it? We didn't write the Quran. We just point out what's in there.
Yeah.
And people don't like it. So they call us hate preachers. You know, they call me a hate preacher too. How can they do that? I'm such a nice person.
So here's the thing. If they, when they don't like you, they call you hate preacher, that means they're calling Quran to be hate preacher. They've got nothing else because they cannot defend the Quran. They cannot stand for the Muhammad, and they know Quran has been corrupted. Muhammad is not a good moral example. Only thing they do is call Lizzie a hate preacher.
And you.
I know you are a lovely person.
I am lovely.
But when he comes back, he will pray behind the Imam al-Masjid.
If you want to have a
okay, I will control. But listen, Hatun. I want to say one thing, yeah? In James Bible, King James, yeah? And all of the 10 Bibles, all of them.
What is this all 10 Bibles?
All the different.
Last time, you made a claim that Genesis was.
I was mistaken.
Okay, but, can you apologize, please?
No, I apologize for not bringing the right reference.
Okay.
But I want to say 10 different chapters in the Bible, Jesus say, I pray to God.
Give me the chapters.
Who is that God you pray to?
Give me the chapters.
10.
Give me the chapters.
And also...
Give me the chapters.
Yeah, I'm going to give you them right now.
First, give me the chapters.
I'm waiting for you.
Sir, give me the chapters and then I will deal with them.
Okay, but I'm waiting.
Give me the chapters.
Okay.
10 chapters.
10 chapters where Jesus said, I pray to God. Who is the God he's praying to? Who is that?
Sir, give me the chapters.
People of Speaker's Corner, you're famous for your 32 versions of the Quran. Yeah. Have you ever experienced violence?
I wouldn't say I am famous, but I am regular at Speakers Corner. I am here week after week. Yes, one of the research I have done was to look at the claim that Quran is all over the world, is one and only. I put together 32 different Arabic Qurans with thousands of textual variations. As you can understand, that didn't go very well. Yes, there were the times that we had harassments, we get death threats, or we get violence has been practiced, but it does happen, so that's
so
normal.
You know the bad.
You act like a baby.
Thank you very much.
So because you act like a baby, I brought you present, which has been around with me for a while. That's your present. So acting like a child and like a baby on a public debate. Yes, especially both for you. Now it's time for me to get rid of it.
You know what this?
Is
this milk?
Congratulations!
Can you open it for me?
Congratulations for acting like a baby in a public debate. So.
Yeah. Okay, here we are with Miss Hatun. She is otherwise referred to as Lioness of Speaker's Corner.
I would say Christian woman.
The Christian lady who has been very strong.
Speaker's Corner.
Yes, exactly. And basically my main thing was, number one, how long have you been actually coming to Speaker's Corner and debating?
Since 2002.
Okay, so it's been quite a long time.
It's been a long time.
And
when I was young.
Were you, I assume you're Turkish, am I right?
Turkish,
you're Turkish. So were you born in a Christian family, or were you...
Christians make their choices to live as a Christian, so I made a choice to live as a Christian.
Okay, but what, your family are not Christian?
They're not Christian.
They're Turkish, Muslim mostly.
It's okay.
My main thing, actually, that's just a little bit of background, really, not anything important. My main thing is, since 2013, and I would presume that cameras kind of came into Speaker's Corner around...
Much later.
Yeah, like 2016, 2017, that sort of thing. How have you felt things have changed since the cameras, and also how have your interactions with, like, the Muslim groups have changed in, let's say, the last 3 years, 3 or 4 years?
Since my first visit to Speaker's Corner, one of the things hasn't changed is Dalmatians always been majority at the Speaker's Corner.
Yes.
And they always are here to attack the other faiths, instead of like sharing what is the good news of Islam, if there is any good news. In early years, you were able to have proper discussions and debates at Speaker's Corner. Like, you would go home with like, oh, I was asked 10 questions, now I need to find answers to those 10 questions. Since the comrades entered the Speaker's Corner, as you can see, lots of Dawatimis at the corner just to be fame. Just to, like, people, even Dawati people, make their living from the YouTube channels. So that changed all the dilemma since the comrades entered the Speaker's Corner. So I think I would say a year after that, Muslims become more nastier.
You feel that there's a lot more sort of an aggressive behavior.
The
aggression has come up.
Aggression comes.
This is another present for you.
Is this Christmas gift?
So here's another present for you. Since looks like your surname is not enough to cover the shame you brought to yourself and Israel Dawati, this is an extra gift for you. Hopefully it will cover the shame you brought to the Islamic community. So
your tents become more aggressive.
Yeah, or the level of aggression, like intimidation. Has risen.
Yeah. We didn't have that much.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
No problem.
Is that good?
Yeah,
thank you.
Let me get you in the frame.
Actually, just mostly Hatun.
So no, it's fine.
She's because I mostly want your opinion. Do you feel? I mean, I want to. I don't know if are you comfortable talking about some of the physical intimidation that you've had in this area? Because I've heard rumors, and I just want to confirm that when men were like in a very sort of tight circles around you, was there any physical contact with you? Because I just want to confirm if that is true, because there's a lot of rumors.
So first of all, don't believe when you hear everything.
Okay.
Even don't believe what you see on the cameras. But it is very common when one female is around between like 20 Muslim men who are trying to shut you down. You see Muslim men's private parties on your body, and you know, like, that shouldn't be that.
Okay, so there has been actual physical contact.
Yeah. And I did express that in the past to kind of Muslim missionaries who's got authority at Speaker's Corner, and all I got was like, they are laughing. And even Muslims are making fun now that I'm accusing them for those kind of things.
Okay, this is what I mean. These are the rumors that I'm trying to clear up, because I hear a lot of rumors, but I don't know what to believe anymore. The other thing is, have you actually complained to any, apart from the Muslim authorities, the actual authorities, police or anyone else?
Yeah, so sadly lots of things are allowed at Speaker's Corner. So the thing you would see as a harassment or abuse, Muslims doesn't see that as a harassment or abuse at Speaker's Corner. And other thing is, I was in a place where, like, middle of the conversation, I am engaging with like kind of authoritative Dawati. Muslim man is like behind me, he's like physically touching me, which shouldn't be happening because that wasn't bedroom and I'm not his wife.
Of course, generally, yeah.
When you turn to the Dawati and I say, like, please tell your brother to leave, all he does is just like, oh, what did you do? And that guy says, oh, I didn't do anything. So there is like intentional, like, takia going go between them, and then no one is like working on it. But like, it's sadly it become the nature of Speaker's Corner for last couple of years, and like, all in my mind is it is because this is Islam teaches women are not kind of, women doesn't have the value, dignity. I'm not only woman, I'm not an ex-Christian woman. I'm not Muslim woman. That's what they view towards me, is what Islam teaches them to be.
How have you changed your behavior since these things have happened? How have you conducted yourself or organized yourself in such a way where these things won't happen?
Well, in the beginning, I was like being just nice. Now, like, I'm not that much.
I noticed. You're very, very quite forward and like, sort of forthcoming with your ideas.
Like, in the beginning, you seem to say, okay, just give me space.
Sure.
But you notice that doesn't work. So what you do, you talk to the person and then you confront that person. That's not a bad word. And last time when I checked, I wasn't your wife. So control yourself. If you can't control yourself, just go back to your wife. That's all it is. So,
obviously you would feel that. What I mean is, have you since then, because I heard rumors again of you since these sort of things, and other women have had the, like Lizzie, do you know anything from Lizzie? Has she experienced anything like this?
Like, everyone should speak on themselves, but as I said, that's very common to get speakers going.
Hartoon round two, but it's got to be a proper thing. We get her to the side, and me and her, and I dismantle her. I dismantle her differently, you get me? I show her what time it is, bruv. Like, she's got her hiking bag and everything, yeah? I will make her hike up to the Everest mountain, fam. You get me, man? I will put it on her scientifically, logically, spiritually, even physically, I will put it on her. Like, I will do her the sexy dance, you get me? But I will show her.
There she is, man. What are you talking about?
Let her finish with the guy. She's with the guy, man. Oh. We can't just interrupt. You know how she gets upset? She'll be like, don't interrupt me. Like that. I told you. If you want to talk, talk with respect. So obviously, man can't interrupt her right now. Let her finish with her brother.
Listen, I'm seeing up, peel up your nostrils.
If I want to do Muta with you, there's nothing wrong with I want to do Muta with you.
Perfect.
Because it's from God. It came down right from God. If I want to do Muta with you, I can give you a present. Here, I can give you a present now. And I give you a Muta. I can do a Muta with you right now. I can give you a perfume.
No, don't get excited.
No, I can give you a perfume.
I'm just saying,
I can give you a present. I can give you my British passport.
Yeah, so
I can give you anything you want.
Sir,
I can give you anything you want.
That's what I'm trying to figure out. You cannot say that to the Christian woman.
What do you mean? What's it got to do with Christian or Muslim?
There is no place in Christian scripture that be married temporarily for 3 hours. There is no place for that. So. Let me ask my question.
I'm going to marry you for 1 year for £1,000. Yalla. Do you accept the marriage? I'm going to marry you for 1 year for £1,000. Yalla. Bismillah. That's for you.
Isn't that difficult to get a wife?
No, I'm just saying. This is her dowry.
No, that's not the dowry. Why do you find it hard to get married?
That is not the dowry. You pay for the sexual intercourse you are going to have with her. So my question was very simple. Why?
You didn't answer my question. I said, what's the difference between fornication and marriage? Answer me this right now. If you don't answer me, then you have failed as in life. Yalla. Bismillah. No. What's the difference? I'm going to repeat it one more time. Between fornication and marriage. Yalla. Answer me this question.
Marriage takes place between one husband and one wife until death parts them. As soon as you sleep with someone.
That's not a good explanation.
You pay to someone for sex. That is fornication.
Okay.
Is sin.
Are you allowed to divorce?
I haven't finished.
Are you okay?
I am looking from the perspective that actually this is one of the way Muslims can say, okay, she gets annoyed at speaker's corner. This is the way we can make her annoyed. Therefore, she goes at home and I don't know whatever woman do at home. So one of those kind of at home things.
Okay. How about like organizing yourself on steps and having other Christian men around you? Is that been something that you guys been consciously thinking of doing? You did it consciously, or has it just been accidental?
No. So we had like kind of people. And while we were up on the ladder, people were coming and like touching you inappropriately stuff, or they were like too much close.
Even when you were on the ladder?
So we moved the ladder back, or even though we are intentional that we are pairing up or with the team. Like currently I am not with my team, like there is no one from here in my team. But
I'm your team.
I can't see who you are actually.
Sorry, that's too much light. Hello.
but it's because Muslims are the majority, and our intention with that speaker's corner, we preach Christ crucified, and we keep them accountable for what they believe. It is very difficult for me to stick with you for like whole day. That's like practically too much. It doesn't work because like, you get tackled by someone else, you get into different conversations.
Yeah. Okay, so it's not practical to organize yourself in a very specific location all the time.
I think
you move around.
Like best way to get rid of those harassments or get rid of those kind of
behavior
is they need to give up Islam, because it is Islam makes them. Like if you in the conversations, if you hear how they talk to you, not to you as they talk to me, that kind of gives the right to the Muslim. They can treat you in that way. The conversation just turns out and says, oh, she's mischievous. The implication of that to Muslims is different than the implication of that to non-Muslims is different. So when Dawati calls you, oh, you are kafir, what does Quran say? She's the kafirs are the worst of creatures. Yeah, so that kind of puts the boundaries.
Well, I mean, my problem with like telling Muslims you can't, you know, to give up Islam in order to not abuse women, that doesn't seem practical. That seems like a much longer goal that you may not be. I'm looking at more of a like realistic solution of like other Muslims holding these types of Muslims accountable, because I think that even if Muslims believe you're a kafir and maybe you're not clean or whatever, they still believe that women should be treated with respect. I know lots of Muslim men who would not want their wives, their daughters, their own people,
the majority,
to be like that. So you can as a human being, you can still communicate with the other Muslims and say, look, would you like it if these men were doing this to your wife, to your mother, to
and
your
also
sister?
My friend.
Oh no!
If you pay,
yes or no?
You give the ring to your wife.
Yes or no?
If you pay, that ring is for me to have sex with you.
So when I go to the church, when I go to the church and I give you a ring, this is prostitution?
It's a commitment.
Hold on, your commitment is for sex. No, how? So what?
If I do, and I don't have sex. Do you have
sex? Okay, what?
No sex.
Yeah, what if I do?
Show me where.
In Saudi Arabia, in Iran, on these Islamic countries, I haven't seen a child to wear hijab. But in this country, they wear hijabs.
Well, they
change. So who do you blame them? Do you blame the system? Because they should be accountable for that.
I'm trying not to distract.
So, for example, in here, Muslims, if they choose to be like.
So you're saying the Muslims are not behaving like Muslims here? Is that your?
No, what I'm saying that this is this country, because it is different, and even the child is wearing a hijab and nobody says anything about it. But in Iran, you cannot find that. In Saudi Arabia, you cannot find
that. You are in the different land.
So
your identity becomes Muslim. Islam becomes your identity instead of like who you
are. So why they shouldn't tackle that?
Well, yeah, I mean, my main thing is I just want to tackle this issue here because I think we're going to go too far away from what's happening in Iran and Saudi Arabia. I'm more concentrated about how people conduct themselves at Speaker's Corner.
Approximately 2 years ago, when I went to Dawah, the men asked them to control the Irman. It's getting out of control. They haven't done anything about it. That was 2 years ago. Again, it was one of the winter. And I remember I told that one of the Dawah, who's a very good authority, just on the other side of the fence. And then all he did was like, he just laughed and walked away. So Islam doesn't keep people accountable to one another.
This is
if one of my Christian brother does any approach to
anyone, like, a woman,
like man or woman, he will be disciplined.
By the Christians.
Yeah, like everyone would call him, everyone would talk to him and say, that was wrong, you got to repent and you got to
repent. That's my, that is my main aim at this whole thing, is I want to bring a light to behaviors of people who don't seem to have any accountability. No one holds them accountable. And if Muslims want to like talk about how they're good Muslims, they're pious Muslims, and they should respect women, because I can imagine that if you were a Muslim woman, if you were wearing a hijab, and men did that to you, a Christian man gathered around you and touched you, exactly, there would be a very different reaction.
Muslims are very protective of their women.
Yeah, they are.
Yeah, but that's what I mean is, I want them to...
You must not even sniff at their women the wrong way.
Why should they only protect their women? Their women?
Yeah.
You should protect all women.
Yeah, no, but to them, if you're not a Muslim, you're mushrik.
This is what I'm trying to highlight is, I don't think that Muslims, when they say
they evolved like that.
Yeah, but
these ones are wrong representation of them.
Like they say that they do, because a lot of Muslims always talk about, oh, we respect everyone, we live in this society, and we have respect.
But why don't you?
Clearly don't.
Mrs. Hatun. Mrs. Hatun.
Yeah,
without guns. And I'll tell you one thing. If these people got their hands on guns, we Muslims, we would be in danger. I'm telling you, there are hate preachers who publicly, openly preach hate every single Sunday and otherwise on their channel. They are hate preachers. They are haters.
Make a video of your hate preaching soon.
Who are out there who call themselves Christians
properly?
Let me respond.
DCCI is terrorists.
Wait, please. Let me. I don't own them.
Let me respond. Is the manifesto of the killer.
Can you move?
84 pages manifesto
Look,
of the killer.
The problem is, Hatun,
Let me finish.
Your voice penetrates people's brains.
Please. Adnan, you came to me. Let me finish.
Can we have a discussion?
I'm trying to have a discussion. You are not letting me speak.
Can you not shout? Because when you shout, you damage my brain cells.
I can.
And I value my brain cells very much. Can you not shout? Can you not shout? Hatun, can you not shout?
I'm not going to shout. If they heckle me, I will be shouting.
They have nothing to do with me. Why are you shouting at me? If they are torturing you, shout at them. Torture them. Your voice is torture. When you shout, it's torture.
Listen, this is Saudi Arabia.
I refuse to be tortured.
Yes, women can speak. Are you talking? Let her speak.
Okay.
Let her speak.
Are you her spokesperson?
See, that's what I'm saying. You can't even let the woman speak.
Okay.
Can we have a discussion?
Adnan.
Can we not shout? Do we have an agreement?
Did you read the manifesto?
Hatun.
Answer the question.
Hatun, you came to me.
What kind of a person are you? What kind of a person are you? I always wonder what's inside you. What's inside you? You're not a Christian. He's not a Christian.
So here's the problem.
I've seen better Christians. I have seen decent Christians around the world. I have debated some of them. They are scholars.
He's putting my life in danger. Let me ask my question again, Adnan.
Can you not shout?
If you listen carefully, then I won't.
Do we agree that we won't shout? Do we agree?
Stop being so feminine.
Do we agree?
Grow up.
All you have to say yes, we agree.
Grow up. Did you write the manifesto?
I'm grown up. That's what I'm saying. Do not shout.
As a grown up.
I'm grown up.
Did you write the manifesto?
Are you grown up?
Did you write the manifesto?
Can we not shout?
Did you write the manifesto?
Good. Do we have an agreement? We will not shout.
Did you write the manifesto?
Do we have an agreement?
Did you write the manifesto?
Hathun, you can finish this by saying yes, we have an agreement. Do we have an agreement that we will not shout?
Did you write the manifesto?
The tape recording is broken.
Can't even answer the
ladies and gentlemen, those of you who are watching, you are watching exactly what hate preachers become. This is what they become. They become irrational. They become bigoted. They become completely psychotic. This woman is a psychotic woman. And I've seen decent Christians condemning her behavior. I've seen decent Christians on their videos. On their videos condemning their behavior. This is not Christian behavior.
So
I'm requesting something simple and she cannot answer my question. Can we not shout? Do we agree that we will not shout?
So let me respond.
She became Christian. Yeah, that's okay. If it works for you, that's good. But it is impossible, as you say, to change 2 billion people to not to be Muslims. You know,
always argue about it. To become non-Muslim, just to become better
people. It is impossible.
I'm saying that if you care about your women the way you say then you should extend
they
that
do really.
and have the same respect for all women.
You know, in my
and if you don't, if you're treating someone like Hathun, although I know you are an exception because you come here and you put yourself in this environment and you are challenging them as well, so it kind of upsets them. Just because you are a confident person that does that, that doesn't mean they have to treat you worse than they treat
Muslims,
other women. This is my argument.
But they don't come to interfere in your...
Wait.
Of the dawah thing is even commentable.
Sorry, give us some volume, please.
I had a guy who
Sorry, I'll edit this bit.
So put the note on my pocket, which says, shush, I'm gonna kill you. And then another guy was like harassing me all day. I went to the Dawati all day. He was in conversation with one of the Dawati. All he does is just say, oh, he's not doing anything.
Well, they deny it. They just deny it.
Therefore, in my mind, while Christians those people who are in the authority and speakers corner come to express their freedom of speech, the way they treat you gives the signal to the rest of the Muslim world.
This is the whole purpose of what I'm trying to do is I want to build, and I've been talking to other people like Manny. I think you spoke to Manny the other night on the live stream and stuff. I'm trying to talk to as many people as I can to try to raise an awareness in this area that some women are not safe in this place. I feel that there are men here who are actually, they think that just because Speaker's Corner is a free speech zone, that they can actually be physical with people. And I think that we should talk about this, we should highlight this, and hopefully, I'm not expecting the Muslim elders to do something. I'm expecting the police, I'm expecting the government, because that's the people I pay taxes to. I don't pay taxes to Dawah team. I pay taxes to this government. Jizya. You're going to pay jizya. Yeah, well, what I mean is I don't pay the jizya, I pay tax. And the tax is for people in this country to come and be protected, to be safe, to feel safe. This is the point of this government, this is the point of this country, is so that we pay our taxes and the government protects us. And if they're not doing that, then that is something that we should address. We should
talk about it. Is he a Muslim?
I'm responding, wait.
No, you don't answer. Look, if this is going to be... Look, she's going to have a dialogue. This is one way.
No, you can't have a dialogue.
This is one way. All she wants is a monologue, not a dialogue. It's a monologue, not a dialogue.
You asked a question.
Yes, I did. Why did she quote a non-Muslim orientalist? Why did she quote a farmer who is a non-Muslim orientalist? Look, this shows the hypocrisy.
Look at Turkish translation. Allah is making dua
by a Muslim, not a non-Muslim.
Dua is a prayer.
What are you going to say?
So can we use
a prayer?
Can we? Did you see that?
And it has been also placed Christians, Muslims, atheists, Buddhists,
to come and express their freedom of speech. But when our actions become personal, instead of dealing with the ideology, we will...
You might miss the clarity. She's talking about like, the way she's been assaulted by the...
Whatever you say, whatever I say, because we have the Islamic scripture, and the Islamic scripture doesn't give very good view to me as a non-Muslim, as a someone who critiques Islam, therefore I do not expect Dawah to change that.
Oh no, this is not mine, this is it.
It's not going to change, because first they need to deal with their
own internal.
But as I said, if the things we are expressing, we are seeing at Speaker's Corner, happens to a Muslim woman, should it be on BBC, and all Christian work will be on them. Yet, all I get is that Muslims are just making double fun of me, because I'm just complaining men's private parties are in somewhere that shouldn't be. Just doesn't help anyone. And my intention to speak, I live outside of London, I travel like long distance to come to Speaker's Corner. And all my intention is, I love to preach Christ crucified, I love to defend Christ and keep Muslims accountable for what they have been saying. And just
but not all of them. Not all of them. Just the one, a tiny minority.
Not gonna have anyone for worship, because I'm still gonna come. But I have sensed that Lord Jesus gave me this calling that I need to get Speaker's Corner. And as I expressed my intention for Muslims to repent and worship Lord Jesus Christ, as soon as Muslims are out there, as soon as I have breath to live, I will be at Speaker's Corner. Even like whatever happens at Speaker's Corner, it's not gonna work on if the strategy is, oh, that way Hatun can stay at home and then do like house things.
I agree with you, but the thing is, sorry, can we move? Let's move over here a little bit more.
The lantern.
No, what I was, you see, my thing is, fair enough, you are a very strong person. You will still be here.
I am here just to adjust the
intensity. More than that, let's be honest, you're much more personal. Your personality is strong. Of course you are. I'm saying you're strong in the sense that you can take.
By God's grace.
You can take all the harassment. So, my concern is, there are many women who may want to come here and won't come. And so, because I hear all the time people complaining, oh, there's not enough women at Speaker's Corner. Well, of course there isn't if they're going to get harassed and touched and attacked in that way. So there will be more women if women felt safe in this environment. But women, men don't feel safe in this environment, let alone women.
Last 3 years, and especially during the winter, it gets darker.
Exactly, right
like
now.
More active.
Yeah.
But it's not gonna.
That's my whole premise is I want this place to be absolutely welcoming for everyone, and I want it to be a place where people genuinely feel safe, feel comfortable.
Okay, listen carefully. Me follow who? Prophet Muhammad. Yeah. Prophet Muhammad said, when you speak to Christians, speak about the oneness of God. You wouldn't do that.
Where does he say that?
Prophet Muhammad.
I'm looking at these guys and them Christians. I don't think, where did it go wrong? But it went really bad.
We expose your lies. That's why you don't like it. Where are you going?
I have a question.
I have a right to remain silent.
You don't have an answer for it.
Ali,
do you have an answer for it?
Ali,
no, I don't want to talk.
Wallahi, really?
No, Arabic.
Don't go there. Why?
We just want to know if it's different. Why?
Next one.
You're a big man.
You don't know Arabic. Speak up the Quran.
I can read it, but I can't speak. Not qualified to speak on these subjects.
Okay, what are you qualified to speak on, sir?
I'm telling you.
Don't be so aggressive, please. Okay,
exactly. So before we start,
don't be a terrorist like you are.
No sensitive.
Right. Okay. Let me just clarify.
You're accusing me of terrorism.
I am a Christian. Can you apologize to me calling me terrorist?
You are a terrorist, and I'll show you why.
Without any shame. Look at him. Is there any shame in his face? Your mom would be shamed of you. Your Allah is shamed of you. And that's not enough. Muhammad is shamed of you.
Allah. Oh my gosh. That's good.
I think that what your story, and probably, hopefully I can talk to other people as well, maybe Lizzie and other people, and get everyone's story and you know, shine a light on this situation. Because I think this is something that is not being expressed loudly. This is like you've said, you've told some people, but then you got ignored. And then I hear rumors about things that happened to you and maybe Lizzie. I don't know about Lizzie, I haven't really spoken to her. But what I mean is, I've been hearing rumors, but it's always been rumors. And rumors can never get anywhere, because people can't say for sure this happened or this didn't happen. The only way we can do it is by having a talk with you, having a talk with people who feel, people who speak out about this.
Even though sometimes there are harassments that speak is gonna mocking, bullying, all those kind of things, still, every individual needs to practice their freedom of speech. But if you are watching Speakers Corner at home and you just what you saw that you don't want to have the Speakers Corner, there are lots of nice things happens behind the cameras. So don't believe whatever you see on YouTube. Like, I don't even watch YouTube because I don't want to believe what's happening on YouTube. But don't allow that to keep you at home. Because every individual needs to practice their freedom of speech. Every individual, like in here, you can freely say and critique whatever you want to do. Like, please don't stay at home because you watched a video that you saw someone got harassed or got bullied. Speaker's Corner is not the place for that. It happens, but it's not the place for that. So you do get a very, very good and fruitful conversation here. You get to learn lots of things at Speaker's Corner. I learned to fall in love with Lord Jesus more and more from Speaker's Corner, because I come here and then I get to know my Bible better. I get to practice. I need to love for those who persecute me. I need to practice that I need to pray for those people who persecute me. I need to practice that I need to love them. That's like very, this is like very good place for Christians to go through their spiritual discipline list and then see how they can improve. So don't stay at home because you watch the video. Like behind the cameras, it is very good place where people freely engage their
certain harassments you get in for the work. Thank you so much, Ms. Hatun. It's been a pleasure. Thank you.
Singing and praising the Lord. The faithful gather to pray. They are here to learn about their religion. Though of different backgrounds and age, they have one thing in common. Nearly everyone in this room used to be a Muslim. Pastor Hazem is the man who runs the Kurdsman Church. He says peace and love made nearly 400 Muslims in Erbil convert to join his Christian evangelical church.
We teach people to live in peace and coexist together, and that's Jesus' message to humanity.
If Christianity were true, and it meant you had to give up everything to follow God, would you want to know the truth?
So, Muslims always tell us that we cannot, the Quran cannot be translated, that we can never understand the Quran, yeah? So, if we can never understand the Quran, why are all these English-born, English-speaking Muslims, if they can't understand the Quran, if it can't be translated, you know?
So, there are lots of problems with, we cannot fully understand the Quran. One of the reasons is, first of all, even Allah says in the Quran is well explained, well detailed, and for all mankind, if I cannot understand the Quran, the language I speak, then I am afraid I know two languages. I'm Turkish, I can speak English and Turkish, yet Allah is not able to communicate with me. It says something about the character and attributes of Allah. I am more, much, much better qualified than Allah.
Watching and listening to something that was going on,
yeah,
and obviously gang, the mature gang, you know, guiding a new generation, were there, and one of the people in gang wasn't comfortable with me standing behind them, so they reported me to the police, and the police pulled me over and asked me, basically insinuated and asked, basically told me indirectly if I could leave the park.
No.
And obviously we said no.
That is crazy. No one's leaving the park.
Obviously
crazy.
We said no. And the officer even said that we didn't commit any crime.
Yeah.
But he still decided to pull me over to talk to me.
It's a path of what it is here. That so, they're allowing the bullies to kind of run
and
the park and get people out. No.
Cops are the ops.
Yeah, we're not going to leave.
No, I don't understand.
Cops are the ops sometimes.
Sometimes they're not.
Yeah, so well, obviously we're not leaving. So that's just that.
We have Sophia.
We're waiting for Raj. I don't like media. You're a prick. And I am going to say, I am telling the police that you threatened me to cut my head off and referred to Lee Rigby. And I will be go live media and I will be telling the police. So yeah, you are a prick.
I don't know them, but I'll take your word.
Go live extreme.
I don't know who these people
are. Yeah, he is extreme. Cutting to chop my head off.
I don't know.
He's an ISIS supporter.
Apparently some
he's a follower.
Why, are you ashamed of being a Muslim?
The whole country is burning. No. And I'm being banned.
You're not ashamed of being a Muslim.
Because
so why don't you say what you believe? Why are you
and
lying?
On top of that, and on top of that, he's now in a no-fly zone when her kids are in France.
What's all this Takiya going on?
I wouldn't know his opinion.
Excuse me. I can't even take you as a Muslim.
You drink
this
corner.
You
Muslim, haram, or just as a human being?
You drink.
Halam.
You drink. You drink.
Whatever.
So what happened?
So obviously my dean came over. And I said I can. If you don't like me, go to a mosque. And then basically, I won't really.
Yeah, he's like, but you're gonna have to tell the police that he's got. Sorry, Mr. Rex. You've got to do what's right.
I think that is proof now that Modine does beat women. He threw water on me. It could have been something else. So you know.
Yeah.
So obviously, Modine's a prick.
All right. Sorry, Sophia. You're okay to film?
Yeah. They're just talking about how women need to start to come to Speaker's Corner more.
Yeah.
Because there's not enough females at Speaker's Corner, and the reason why they're not coming is because it's quite male-dominated. It's quite intimidating, especially if you have men throwing things over women. Just 2 weeks ago. No wonder why. Yes, yeah. Which is why we're saying we need more women to come.
But the thing is, if women do come, they always get shut down when they talk to people, talk out loud.
Yeah, it's
men just feel like they've got the more high ground of all of it.
But you should have like a female circle, like it's female only kind of like discussion.
Yeah. And let me ask you guys, as females, would you be happy to have trans women inside a female circle?
Of course.
I don't know if certain females want though.
Yeah. Are trans
not, not just,
women,
but legally
women.
Too.
Honestly, it's so.
Me and Sophia are cool, but there is a lot of hostility towards her from certain communities and even some females as well.
Yeah.
So some people are saying she's not female, even though she's had a gender reassignment and legally is now a female.
Yeah, she's still female.
Exactly. So, and this is the thing, people seem to think that trans women are not really accepted and stuff, but I'd say for the most part they are, but you will obviously you always have a few that don't accept people and stuff. But yeah, so women, you need to start coming to Speaker's Corner.
Yes.
So less more women start to come.
Kick all the men out.
Yeah.
Especially Moses.
The only reason I'm saying maybe do a female only section is because I do that. I'm Sikh. And sometimes when you're trying to talk about a particular topic about your own people, people start interfering. So what I do is like have a specialist kind of Sikh kind of discussion only. Yeah, that way you can contain the conversation.
Yeah,
and
that's it, guys.
Yeah, that's
just basically, we were talking before. You actually came earlier.
I know, there was so much.
Oh,
see how easy
this.
Yeah,
we were talking a lot. You lot missed it.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's it.
The women should definitely
Hi, Captain Rambo. Do you still have like your speech impediment that you have?
Yeah.
You know, like the speech impediment that you have, like you're gonna.
I don't mind talking to
Crapton Rambo, but he's gonna have to speak slowly because his speech impediment. I find it hard to understand him.
No.
Just pronounce your words slowly. Like the thing is that you can actually have speech therapy on the NHS, so he has absolutely zero excuses.
Yeah, I will talk to the police, and I have the evidence here, and I'm showing it to the police. So if you're watching, you're a prick, and I'm showing it to the police.
Are you a Tommy fan? You're a fan of Tommy Robinson? I'm just curious.
Why would you say, is it white?
I love white people. No, I have white friends. I'm not racist. I love white people. I work with white people. I've got several white friends. I'm not a racist.
Why would you ask that?
I'm just curious.
Why would you get so tricky?
I'm forced to answer you in the comment, you fucking idiot.
Do you know what? You've been asking me to come on here. I came on and I'm jumping, but silent.
Do not call my name in it. Don't fuck it up. I don't have nothing to do with you.
Oh my God, shut the fuck up. I'm not going to do anything.
Go fuck.
How was your experience on that live feed? I haven't watched
it. People were so disrespectful.
Two rolls of sellotape later.
They're really disrespectful. They need to understand that in the UK, and a lot of people, I'm going to say, were Somalians. Do they know Somalians were raped like the thickest people in the UK in 2017? No offense, you're Somalian.
One more month to go.
Red donkey. Where's Shrek? Where's Shrek? Where's your secretary,
Saida? How do we stop this?
Where is she?
Speaker's corner.
Obviously, me being trans, they hate that, so they came over and started screaming abuse. So then I shouted abuse back, and then they don't like it.
He said under this law I don't need to tell them.
Under the Gender Recognition Act of 2004, February 16th, I do not need to tell anyone. It's been changed on my birth certificate to female.
That's not rape by
It's not rape by decision. Excuse me. If you have a problem, you need to confront the law.
Batty boy, you understand? So tell Simon to say, Gwen, chuck off your pussy off, you little fish.
Captain, come please.
Can we acknowledge the irony of him calling me a fish? That is that.
No, you're a fish. You're a fish. That's what we say. You're a fish. You're swimming in everything.
You're old enough to be my dad.
Gwen, Dotty. No, your dad should be disappointed
like,
in you.
Home somewhere.
I'm your dad, be disappointed in you. Abandon you, you little son of mine. Fuck off, man.
Whoa. Oh, you can't fucking do shit. Do you know, I've seen off, you in the park and like, you
oh,
walk around
you
like
in the park.
Granddad in your t-shirt and that you
no, wear. No, I've seen you in the park. And I've shown,
yeah,
I've seen you in the park.
What, you haven't anything to me. Shut the fuck up.
Who wants to talk to his son, Mike? Are you fucking up?
You clearly want to talk to me because you've been begging my attention in the comments for weeks. You absolutely idiot.
Gwe,
go and
Dottie,
suck off her
always
thigh,
to,
like,
I always wanted to tell you. I always wanted to tell you. Stop swimming. No, all I want to tell you is stop swimming.
Do you have a dog?
And also, they complain when I give shit back. Don't complain when I get mad because you're referring to me as a man. If you're going to be disrespectful to me, I'll do that. That's it. Did you realize that why would you come to somewhere where you know you're going to get very upset?
They won't, but they need
to. It's not illegal for me to do that.
So she's legally raping someone, that's exactly it.
Fuck you, Arca.
What's your job, Rambo?
Do I have a job? To stay far from my fucking. That's my job.
Oh,
to
so like the answer is no.
You.
So the answer is no.
Dottie, blood that
down. You want our universal Gwyn. Credit, Captain Gwyn. Rambo.
Don't back if they can't chat to me. Yo, son of my... Gwyn.
I am chatting to you, Gwyn. And you're not going to do anything about
no.
it.
You got the fuck out, you little fucking boy.
Fire for you.
Oh,
Rambo, are you gonna like stop finally being a bitch and actually like hear what you have to say? Yes, we can fucking hear you. We can't understand you though.
Yo, shut up, Adam. Shut up, man. Yeah, you little fucking. You're so disgusted.
We can hear you, but we can't understand you.
Listen, I'm talking, innit?
So shut up. I'm talking, innit? I'm not undermining you. I genuinely want to understand what you're saying so that I can reply.
The reason why I fucking brought you up here, because for weeks you like to write.
So I like said, to write. Come up here. You mean write, okay.
Let me tell you something. Say nothing. I'll buck you up and we will deal with it off this. Because I like...
Are you going to buck me? What?
To do this.
Wait, so can someone translate buck? You know, is that urban
say
slang? Fuck?
No, buck it, boy. Say nothing. We deal with your...
Does anyone know if buck is an urban slang? Fuck. Because Captain Rambo, I'm really not into you like that, honestly. Like, I know you're a bit creepy and you told me to get on all fours earlier, but I really don't want to fuck you.
Say nothing. Yo, say nothing. I say some little gal if we come tear you up now. Yeah? To shut your mouth.
Oh my god, fuck send me. Your gal them. I'm
send
not fucking scared.
Send my little real girls to come and spin you tomboys up, man. So,
you know, Captain Rambo, like, fucking 50-year-old pensioners are just not my type.
Listen, I don't care. Yo! Batty boy, I don't give a fuck back.
He was being really, really nasty.
And what's who?
And go live. Not like a bit normal. More
was
than
he actually
normal.
On a live stream with you guys, or he just
we don't let
he
him
made
on.
The whole live talking about
he loves it.
Saying that I should die and I should slit my throat and how I'm a Sophia iOS 12.0.
Wake up, my brothers! It's all the agenda, you know!
But certain men are with the agenda, bro.
What are we walking up?
Oh, it's not good for everyone.
That's like so fun for him.
Oh, Chichi! Yo, Chichi! Yo, son of a bitch! What the fuck are you talking? What are you talking?
Sorry, 52.
With your white privileged fucking English language, don't come off with all of that shit with me. Yeah?
With my
don't
white that privilege.
That talk with me. Don't use that talk with me. You understand? But I said to you, get on all fours. I said, you are on fours because you're a tame fucking dog. Don't you get it?
Am I going to have to go and scroll through the comments
yeah,
once
it's been done? Yes, go on all fours.
No, I'll do that, especially you, Captain Rambo.
I'm not your captain. Yo, I'm not your captain.
Are you my captain?
I shouldn't be in your fucking
mouth. Oh, Rambo, that's so
cute. I'm not going to do with you. Yo, unicorn. Go fly your unicorn across the rainbow.
Not even a weekend, and he's my captain.
I'm not your... Hey, listen.
What the fuck was
I don't know what that's all about.
Sophia, I always... A lot of people did say that you were like a real genuine woman that's pretending.
Yeah, I know, which is ridiculous. You would pretend to be trans. That's just so dumb.
Listen, we don't even... That ain't even a genuine part.
We just want to listen.
No, we don't... Did I say you should kill yourself because you are trans?
No, I'm letting you know. You seem to be confused why I don't like Muslims.
Are backy boys anyway. Most of you racists are all.
No, you look really nice.
Fuck off, man.
Denim.
Fuck
is that
lady
like a, boy. You got like a denim jacket
shut
on.
I bet the NHS is paying for your transformation, you know? The NHS, I pay my tax to pay for your fucking shit. For your gay shit. Shut up, man. Shut up, man. Standing up. Shut up, man. You can't even produce milk. You can't even have children, bro.
Oh my God.
Shut up, man. You're a man. You should be ashamed of yourself. You should be ashamed of yourself. You never got enough loving from your mum and dad. Yeah? You're an abomination to the white race. You're an abomination to the human race.
Oh, you're a bag.
Yeah? You're an abomination. Can't produce milk. You're a freak. You're a dyke. Shut up, man.
My milk.
You're a dyke.
Sorry, but
shut up, man.
You're not going to get my milk.
Shut up, man.
Because they all think that you're part of like MI6's undercover plan to come here with Raj and
we do attract. there's a
whole conspiracy theory built around you now.
What do you mean go to a mosque?
Yeah, you should just go to a mosque if you don't want to hear.
You're the only person clapping me. What are you guys up to?
Where's my samosa? Where's
she wanted to call my prophet. That one is called my prophet, Mary. That wants to call a prophet Muhammad a rapist. That.
Oh.
And you admitted under your law or under the. What is it?
Gender Recognition Act 2000.
You don't need to tell a man that you've transed into a woman.
No, I don't.
Fucking dog. Come off. Go back up in your cave, man. You fucking tranny. Come on.
You're the one that's fucking barking.
Cave,
I can't even understand you. Shut the fuck up.
Go back to your cave. Shut the fuck up. Fuck off, you little son of a... Don't talk like a man. You're a man. Simon, talk like a man.
You love my voice. Talk like a man.
Oh my God, he's in captain mode now. He's telling me what to do. What else should I do, Captain Rambo? You're a fucking boy. Come on.
What else should I do? I love it when you put me in line.
You know what? You're recording this. You're recording this to take to your police dad, innit?
Sorry, go on. That's racist.
I'm not going to respect tonight to your people. Don't call for the deaf people like me.
It's true, man. I think they want to say that. Based on your beliefs.
You don't like it, there's a mosque 5 minutes away.
Of course.
Wait, wait, wait. Do you think that people should be able to come to the same fucking mosque?
No, but that wasn't the question.
The
question is, do you think we should be allowed to?
What we should do, right?
No, is it yes or no?
But don't be offensive.
No, it's a yes or no. Do you think people should be allowed to come here and say it's a fucked
No.
Oh, you don't think that
it's offensive? But like, you criticise,
so, so is it offensive when people say that I should die under Sharia?
Well, that's not good either. That's not good.
So that should be banned too?
What?
Steve.
And sleep with him and cause him psychological damage.
Oh my god.
Rape him by deception. You fucking nuts.
You're such a big baby, aren't you?
You know, he's a nasty woman. She don't like him.
He grow up.
You know, we all used to show respect until she really came to
work.
Yeah, I was in South Wales.
That's all my fault.
That's his guy.
If you want to call me by my birth name, it's Mohammed.
Then you've got to be respectful.
I'm letting you know, but you're talking about respectful. You're being very disrespectful. And the thing is, I'm going to say, oh, there's the two-faced Maku.
Yeah, leave the guy, man.
Yeah, so I'm obviously going to tell the police because that isn't on.
Yeah. I mean, the thing is, it is assault as well.
No, well, to be honest, like, there's no point. If it's Captain Rambo speaking, like, he might as well just zone out because it's quite hard to understand him anyway. I think he has a problem pronouncing almost every letter in the alphabet except his T's and O's, I think. Do you know why? It's because I'm not even angry at Captain Rambo. I just see him as a joke. Like, the guy's actually, I think he's like my dad's age. And so it's kind of hard to take someone like that seriously.
Oh, man.
Especially when they're online arguing with a fucking transsexual. Like, oh, my gosh. That is... And you could tell, like, it's, like, the most exciting thing in his life as well because, like, he's so excited and screaming. But the thing is, he asked me why I came on here. He was the one that asked me to jump on.
Have you ever seen him with anyone?
Do you think
anyone?
It was appropriate to walk around with a phone saying, dude, looks like a lady?
That's going to be heckling.
But last week,
why is that sort of hate okay, but rape hate is not okay?
But let me tell you something. Last week,
if I call you a packy, is that hate?
Oh, that's racist.
So racism bad.
Steve, if I call you a hunky, is that racist?
I know. They
are just triggering. You're triggering. Because they believe you were built.
Are you a part of
Area 55?
No, I'm not a part. No, kind of.
No, no. She's not. I normally do the recruiting.
They said that I needed to bring evidence that I was born a man. Can you believe that?
But I mean, the thing is, there's a
limit.
So, what do you want to do?
Go in Japan to clean my vagina.
Well, she count it. Let's see how much money it is, though.
To show you my vagina.
No, show me what you are, man.
I don't know, right? I don't know which one it is.
Sorry. Oh, yeah. So, you're going to give £300? Did you see that? He just said he's going to give £300. That guy did.
More than that. He just showed it.
That guy. That guy was offering her £300 to see her vagina.
No way.
Yeah, he had
£300.
No, you're mad.
Money up front.
Is that like 10 minutes worth of work?